Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme Tech channel. Guys, so for today's video I'm gonna show you a couple tips and shortcuts on this 12 inch reducer, SCAD 80, 12 inch reducer on a 12 inch 90. So as you can see, this is from my crow shift. They did some, they tacked some dogs to pull that spool together, as a little bit different from that fitting and from that reducer. It's not even gap all the way around, so I'm just gonna grab a grinder, open up wherever it's tight. I'm not gonna cut the tacks. I'm just gonna run a 1/8 grinder. It is feather edge, that's what I like. I'm just gonna open up room, make it more room on top and the bottom. As long as I can wiggle 1/8 inside rod, that's a pretty much good reference for me. Okay, that's what I did. I cleaned it up a little bit, all those marks from the dogs they used, and as you can see here, there's a notch as I was re-beveling and opening up top and the bottom. I'm not worried about it. I'm gonna fix that later with a grinder. I'm gonna weld in between tacks, so pretty much the gap is it's all right. It's not even all the way around, but it's way better than what it was. So I know it's a little bit time consuming, especially in the field, you know, depends from the position. Here it's not too bad, but don't be lazy. Grab a grinder, open up, don't, you know. Okay, so 70S2, 1/8 for the root, 125 amps. I think that's pretty much the, that should be a good amp for this. You can even go a little bit higher. It all depends from your travel speed and how much amps you can handle. The idea for this depends, as I said, the gap is not even, so I'm gonna try lay the wire technique on this side. Keep the rod slightly inside. As you can see here, it's 70S2, especially when it's your pipe, it's not really properly clean from inside. It's gonna be a little bit even harder to manipulate, to have a really good control over that puddle. So try to maintain same steps, same inclination. Try to keep that rod constantly connected to your puddle. You want to have a slightly little build up on your root inside. That's why it's really important to keep it in the puddle and slightly inside the root. And it's, you know, always inclinations changing, guys. Depends. It's not the same on one spot. It's a little bit different on the other spot. Depends. There's lots of factors, your body positioning, your surroundings, everything, you know, obstacles. And the gap is changing. I like to go all the way to the tack, close as I can. So whenever it's tight, it's easier for me just to change the technique. I'm just gonna go back feet technique on a horizontal. Same idea, vertical, horizontal. The back feet is a back feet. Keep the rod inside and just keep it in the puddle. You gotta use the whole length, especially with the bigger diameter pipe. Just grab a whole length of your TIG wire and keep it connected, keep it in the puddle. As you can see here, the back feet, even horizontal, like especially with 70S2, it's a great idea, especially because we all know 70S2, that's specifically designed a rod for dirty application, like this is one good example of that, especially when it's not properly clean. I'm pretty much positive that if they clean it inside properly, I always like to go a couple inches when I clean from inside. It will be probably a little bit easier to manipulate, but to have a control over that puddle. But it's not always ideal. That's the beauty of the field. So just try to keep that rod, keep it in a puddle. If you lose connection, just feed it back. So just maintain, you know, constant feed. Just run it through your fingers, keep it all the time connected, and stretch that puddle. And you can see the build up here, you know, as you know, you got lots of meat inside. As I said, I'm just gonna weld close to the tacks. I'm gonna cut out the tacks, and I'm just gonna fix that the rest of that bevel. As you can see here, that's why this rod is really hard. Is all that all those impurities are from the outside. This is the root. Root looks good, especially for horizontal. I mean, horizontal is always prone to sag down, you know, always got a more build up on the bottom as the gravity. The gravity do that that work. That's why I always try to keep it on the top and stretch that puddle down so you connect both both edges. But it's not a rule, you know, everything always changing. Everything is changes. You can have one constant technique or one constant speed on the same joint. As I said, lots of factors play that role. You know, your body positioning, obstacles around your pipe. Especially in the field, how many times, and that's one of the most frustrating things when you're on a scaffold, and then the scaffolders, they give you like 20 inch, you know, room between that scaffold tube and your joint. I think lots of us have that same experience. And but as you can see, so I was doing layward and I was doing back feed, and now I was holding from the outside. It all depends. So from the outside root, I'm just gonna run a grinder, get rid of all those impurities, all those it's like uneven spots, you know. That one of the reason why it was that hard to manipulate that rod. And just keep it clean, especially for your hot pass. Hot pass should be way, way easier. It shouldn't be any much difference from a 70S6 rod. Just crank that heat. I go 160 for the hat pass. Just gonna run one bead up and down. As long as you got a nice and clean surface below, that should be good. And a good heat, and the amp is gonna cover all those uneven spots on your root pass, and it's gonna keep it clean. As you can see, it's a big difference from that root pass and from a hat pass. Way smoother, way easier to control that puddle. I just keep that rod in the middle and just stretch that puddle up and down. Okay, that's it pretty much. This is for the hat pass. As you can see, it's nice and clean. Just a good habit, guys. Don't be lazy. Grab a grinder if you don't like it. Just do a little touch up, you know, or a buffing wheel, clean it, keep it clean, all your passes. So for the fill, I'm just gonna go two fill passes for this welding procedure. So I'm just gonna do one on the bottom, one on the top. It's just it doesn't really matter, you know, it doesn't have to be in any order specific. You can go one from the top first and then on the bottom. It's just whatever, it's easier for you, it doesn't really matter. You can wiggle, you can walk the cup, you can freehand, whatever you like. You can use bigger cup.
You can always change the size of your cup.
You know, bigger bevel, wider bigger bevel, bevel no, heavy balls.
Heavy ball.
Cup you size 10, 12.
10, 12, depends on how much
just
room
keep
you
your tungsten always sharp. Good amperage, good travel speed. You should have a nice and clean weld. That's the whole idea, you guys. You got, because now you're prepping for the next welding procedure, and that's gonna be a stick in this case, and that's gonna be for the next video. That's the most important thing. Keep it nice. Keep it clean. The prep is important. You wanna have a clear picture. You wanna clean it, and just keep it clean. That's simple. And for the next video, I'm gonna show you guys how to fill it up a little bit faster using. Using a bigger rod. It's gonna be a stick, so I'm gonna do fill and cap for horizontal. So if you guys are interested, you can check it out later. And that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you in the next one. Bye.